The story of the C8 that's being played out right now, around the world. Where is this thing going? Are they going to stop producing this? Have they stopped producing it? Is this stuff still in our environment?
There's a push to have from many corners of the world to stop producing it. But what DuPont now has done is just shifted the production over to China, where where the regulations are far less. The EPA came out with reports. The last review they did, they said that just to show you how small an amount we're talking about, 0.07 parts per billion. In other words, it's the equivalent of a fraction of a drop of water in an Olympic swimming pool. The EPA says that has the ability to be a potential carcinogen, along with other illnesses such as birth defects. All types of neurological concerns. So what's happened is the company now understands, and a lot of American companies understand this, that they can't do business in the United States because there are at least some regulations, no matter how pitiful the regulations are. So they go to countries like China. Now the problem with C8 is once it enters the environment, it's there for 5 million years. That's their own. That comes from DuPont's own documents. It stays in the body 25 years. And once a person gets it in their body, they run the risk for 25 years of contracting cancer and a whole host of other ugly illnesses, such as ulcerative colitis and many more. But the point about it, the point is the spread of this throughout the world, they're finding C8 in the blood of polar bears in the Arctic, in penguins in the Antarctic. That's how ubiquitous this is. It's spreading everywhere. And the company was well aware of this thing called biopersistence, meaning once it enters the bloodstream, it stays there. It's there for at least 25 years. And you know what, Thom? Worse than that, it's cumulative. The last case we tried, the man that we tried had seven times the amount of C8 that even the workers had in their blood that actually worked around this stuff day to day. So the story is getting uglier and uglier. The only thing that'll stop it is having DuPont prosecuted. Unfortunately, right now, DuPont is in the process of trying to merge with Dow Chemical. Dow Chemical doesn't seem to mind that they're merging with really, for all practical purposes, a constructive criminal enterprise. What DuPont did actually to try to get away from the problem was spin all the liabilities off, if you can imagine, Thom. They want to keep all their profits, but they're spinning all their liabilities out to a company called Chemours, which is not long for bankruptcy. So this is the new way of doing business in America. It's called the expendables. They typically go to areas that are poverty-stricken, low income, or they're job deprived. They go into areas like that. They tell them you're going to make a lot of money, but oh, by the way, you're probably going to get we're going to put this stuff that you're making in your drinking water, in your air. Your children will be exposed to it every day. And unfortunately, the American public seems willing to make that trade-off.
Yeah. They, in fact, some of them refer to these places as sacrifice zones. It's pretty bizarre.